Hello and welcome to part 2 of this Bruker microCT training video on the subject of CTVox, the CTVoxel program. Part 1 was an introduction to CTVox, and this part 2 is how to make a movie. Now, the dataset that we have open in CTVox is a scan of a sea urchin from the Skyscan 1272. As we saw in the previous video, when we first open a dataset, we remove the cloud of surrounding ambient air by placing a tick mark in the opacity channel, and then we pull it down to the bottom margin in order to cause the lowest density pixels to become fully transparent. All the pixels below that dot become transparent when it's on the bottom margin. By the way, we right click to turn off the spline so we get straight line interpolation between the dots, and we move the dot to the left until that just before the point at which the cloud appears, so just around about here. And to save time going through all the color channels, we will just load the transfer functions from the gallery that we discussed last time. There's one peak, two peak, and three peak alternatives that can be chosen, which, as their names suggest, have different number of peaks. If we go to the three peak one, we've got a nice looking color effect where we have quite a variegated transfer function with multiple different alternations of color in the range of grayscales. And we again readjust the opacity channel for the best level of overall brightness. And if we're happy with that, we can save that. We'll save and let's just call it sea urchin. To enhance the viewing, in addition to the transfer function, we can also add surface lighting with the surface lighting button. So we will add surface lighting with a diffuse value of around somewhere between 20-30% and a specular value in the range to make it a little bit shiny, something also around about 40%. The surface lighting enhances the surface view to make it a bit brighter. And finally, we can also add shadows. As we talked about last time, a lowish value of shadow percentage prevents the shadow effect coming too much. If it's too high, then you get too much shadow, so sometimes it's quite a small value is required here. We will use 2%. We will plan our movie. We will decide on the numerical increments of our movements, and so to do that we go Control M to open the movements window, and we will set the rotation at 45 degrees. And that means that from a position such as we have here, with a small adjustment, if I rotate horizontally, we're going out of the field of view, so I'm going to make it a little bit further away. Let's try that one more time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 8 rotations keeps the object nicely inside the field of view. Following that, we can choose the face of the cube, which is towards us, which in this case is number 5. And we first of all position the front face so that it's close to just away from the actual object, so we don't have to travel through empty space. And we control this number just to give us a situation where between 7 and 8 clicks are sufficient for us to go all the way through the object. And we are then ready to begin recording the movie. We will do that by clicking on the 5 quarter button, and we will add our first frame. Now, if I click on the top of the window, it becomes active, and I can use the side arrow to implement the rotation. 1, click on add, click on top margin, side arrow on the keyboard, add, and repeat. You can make the sideways movements either with the keyboard arrow or with the yellow icons on the movements window. So we will make 8 rotations of 45 degrees, which will be 360 degrees and bring us back where we started. Now I will click on the number 5 column to make a cut in. And when I make a cut in, I will make a movement forward, and this time 25 steps using the red arrows, a movement forward compensates for the distance of the cut in, so if you get it right, you then lose the sense of your object going further away from you when you make repeated cuts. Just looks a little bit better. So repeat the cuts and the movements forward. Cut, move forward, add, and continue. Until we've cut all the way through the model. Then we can start coming back, so I'll go out, and then in the opposite movement away, and repeat that cycle again until we have returned to the starting point. And we can finish our movie with what we call a fly through. So this time I will move with the mouse wheel, but I'll carefully count the times I roll it. So I'll roll it towards me twice, click on add, roll it another two times, add again, two more rolls and add, finally two more, and we'll be just out of the object in the final add, and we'll go with that for our movie. Now, we choose interpolate frames. How many frames to interpolate between each keyframe? I choose typically between 30 and 40. And you should always end your movie in the same frame as you begin. So if the ending is empty space, then you make the beginning also an empty space by choosing the fade in. You can choose it in fade in and fade out at the beginning and the end. But if we're ending in empty space, then we don't need a fade out. And we'll quickly review our frames by clicking on the next keyframe button. Number one, two, three, so on. And now we've cut through, first cutting in, then cutting back out, and finally the fly through. And that's it, and we're back to the beginning. So now we will make the movie. We'll click on the box, the option for hiding the clipping box. We don't want the clipping box to appear. So we click Save Movie, and let's call it something like Machine Watching Movie. We have to choose a compressor. We normally recommend choosing Microsoft Video 1. The compressor quality can be moved to 100%, and we can click OK, and now wait for the movie to be created. Note that what is happening now is not the display of the actual movies, it's the creation of the frames. The final display of the movie will be much faster. So now the creation of the movie is nearing completion, and once it has completed, the program will automatically launch the default video player. Please note, do not use the Windows 10 player called TV and Movies. It is close to useless. Please use instead the older Windows Media Player, which actually works with large size videos, and then you'll get a satisfactory replay, or you can choose other video players. The movie is complete, and as we can see now, Windows Media Player is launching, and now we see the full speed replay of the movie. I'm going to fast forward here and there just to speed things up a little. Now we're completing our rotation, and it's going to start our cut through. Okay, so there's the movie, and we can save the frames of the movie as well call it sea urchin wreck. So that, in a nutshell, is the essential procedure for making movies in CTVox by using the system of keyframes and interpolation between those keyframes. Thank you for your attention.